See, we are actually, good morning to all. See, as you all know, Kerala is actually in the forefront of every sector, be it health or education. The main reason for it, as you know, is the focus of the Kerala, of the state governments on health, education, and such sectors. And even in the case of IT, in the case of health, we are the forerunners in the country. So we have a beautiful project called eHealth that is running in the state for the past, say, four years. And we are now in the phase of rolling it out across the state in all the hospitals, starting from the primary health centers up to the medical colleges. We have the basic concept of one patient, one EMR. A patient, wherever he goes, doesn't need to carry the medical records along with him. Everything is available online. Any treatment that is done on the public health center or even at the medical college will be available to him online, to every doctor that he visits at any place in the state. We have the public health system also, which is one of the best in the country. Our public health system and the hospital management system are totally integrated in the sense that any person who is diagnosed with NCD or diabetes in the field, he will be automatically alerted by the doctor in the hospital where he can do the follow up and other treatments. We have the way our EHealth system is completely compliant with the international standards like SNOMED, which is the library of what do you call medical terms. This is basically systematized nomenclature of medicine, and the lawing, which is for the laboratory for the labs. And we have all our systems are HL7 compliant. We have the cross hospital referral system. For example, if a lady is pregnant and she wants to be referred to a higher hospital, from the lower side hospital itself, she can be referred to the medical college or women and child hospital in the state through the system. By which, what the advantage that she gets is that she goes to the hospital with a appointment with a token number on a particular date for a particular doctor. So
it's quite interesting about the referral system, where we require the cross hospital seamless.
Exactly.
It's really good because to have the primary and the secondary and the tertiary care,
yeah,
and where the reference system is proper, and then we can implement the strategies and then we can implement the treatment or the prevention, the cure, and everything, and then it comes
exactly
into the picture. It's really, yeah, it's a great achievement from your side.
Yeah,
yeah,
we have the integrated queue management system. I can show you just a screenshot of it. This is actually, is this connected? I don't think so. Okay. This is, I could have showed you the live screen of the queue that is being managed in Trivandrum Medical College in the cardio department or in the general medicine. I think the connectivity is not there. Okay. So moving forward, I'll just directly move to some of the scope where PPP can pitch in. Since the time is very less, I'll just rush through it. See, the hospital management system that we already have is on a SaaS model, by which I mean that currently we are providing the facility of the online system to the government hospitals. Any government hospital in the state can directly come on board. The only requirement that they need to have will be the connectivity and the connectivity power and the hardware. That is also being provided from the eHealth side. For some hospitals, the local bodies are funding. For some hospitals, we have the NHM funding. For some hospitals, we have the state government funding. And moreover, moving forward, any private clinic who wants to have a electronic medical record can just come on board, do their configurations, start their hospital, by which they get the features of an online queue management system, the online reception, the online doctors consulting, the online lab, the online pharmacy. All these things they get by themselves. So a private partner can very well come on board and be part of the eHealth system. The greatest advantage in that system is that the patient will be having a unique health ID. Whether he goes to a private hospital or he goes to a government hospital, his health records will be together, and he can and from our eHealth web portal, he can directly download the his medical records online. We have a system like called PACS, where we have the radiology images. We keep them on a central platform. We are running a parallel project called diabetic retinopathy scanning of retinal scanning for diabetic retinopathy.
Mr. Vinod, and then can you just put on the focus on, because what we are doing in the hospital management system, and then already implementing the many of the states are implementing on that. Can you focus on any other non-communicable diseases or any other thing, and then you would like to focus on that?
Fine. So see, we are having public health management system where we have the tablets in place, and these tablets are distributed to all the field workers in the state, and they collect data on all the NCD data like diabetes other things. These data come to the hospital on the doctor's screen, and the follow-up treatment happens. That is also integrated with the hospital management system. So moving forward, this has some of the scope for PPP. We have whole set of data which can be used by the private player for giving a better healthcare by way of insurance or through any other economic health plans, by which where the government can make a revenue. In the case of hardware and connectivity, for example, we are buying a lot of printers for the hospitals to use. Now we find that instead of buying printers upfront, we can have printing services from the private sector. They will install all the printers, they will manage the consumables, they will manage the ink, they will manage the maintenance, so that, and then we'll be paying them on a per page basis. So this likewise in any hardware sector, instead of government paying upfront for the hardware, we can have services based contracts. Even in the case of connectivity, since health being a very critical.
Yeah, you can. The next. Connectivity, and then we will not take it now. Yeah, please.
Fine,
second.
Fine. Yeah. See, these are some of the challenges that I see in the PPP model. We need to have, like our previous speaker said, the mistrust with the private player is one of the major constraints. We need to have secure processes. We should not have any vendor dependency on while moving forward with the private player. We need to have a strong legal framework over which the clinical governance issues like sharing of responsibility on the healthcare front, the data sharing policy has to be in place, so that what data to share, what data not to share, all these things has to be in place. We have to have standards like SNOMED and national EHR standards. The payment mechanism, what I would say is that since it is health, the public authority will try to put more focus and quality of on the quality front, which will increase the cost of service delivery on the part of the private player. Then managing PPP contracts is another issue. We in government may not be competent enough to manage PPP projects. So that is another inadequacy in government. The rigidity and the flexibility of the rigidity in the government and the flexibility of the private partner has to go hand in hand. So these are some of my thoughts. Since time is lacking, I just stop my speech here. Thanks.